Hello, Lakers Nation. My name is Trevor Lane, senior writer for LakersNation.com, and this is the Lakers Nation NewsFeed, where we break down all the latest happenings in the world of the Los Angeles Lakers. Today's show, we are talking about a mystery player, an all-star player that may be headed to the Pelicans if the Lakers can get a deal done. We've heard that they want an all-star caliber player, and they want the Lakers to go find that player and negotiate a trade with a third team. Now we're hearing a name associated with that rumor, but first, quick shout-out to our sponsor betonline.ag. All you have to do is go to clnsmedia.com/LeBron. That's how they know that you came from us, and use the promo code CLNS50 to get a 50% bonus on your first deposit. All right, so we are hearing that the Pelicans would like the Lakers, in order to land Anthony Davis in Los Angeles, to loop in a third team that would send them an all-star caliber player. We've heard that David Griffin and the Pelicans prefer to get some young assets from the Lakers, possibly some future draft assets, but they would like to use the Lakers' number four pick to shop around the league and try to find an all-star caliber player. So the Lakers would send the four pick to another team. That team would then send an all-star caliber player to the Pelicans. Now we're hearing that that team that the Pelicans would like the Lakers to deal with is the Washington Wizards for Bradley Beal. Now this makes a ton of sense. Look, if I'm the Pelicans, I would want Bradley Beal too. All-star caliber player, made the All-Star team this last season, put up 25-5-5. He's only 25 years old, so he's a young player, could grow with their core, would be an excellent fit. There's a couple of challenges, though. First and foremost, Bradley Beal is probably going to cost you more than just the number four pick. As a young all-star locked into a contract for at least another couple of seasons, he's going to carry more value than that number four pick would. So what else would have to get thrown in? And would that come from the Lakers? Or would that come from maybe the Pelicans taking a little bit less from the Lakers and instead sending that over to the Wizards in order to get Beal? So that's going to be a question. They'll have to try to figure out the value. The other thing is that the Wizards front office may not even be in a position where they can trade Bradley Beal. You see, they fired GM Ernie Grunfeld not long ago, and so without a GM in place, is their front office prepared to make such a massive decision as to part with their most valuable asset in Bradley Beal? Look, John Wall is on a supermax contract that is going to be just starting. It's the worst contract in the NBA at this point because Wall unfortunately suffered an Achilles injury. That is going to be a really, really tough thing to build a team around with that contract eating up most of their cap space. So the question is, do the Wizards see it as better for them to trade Bradley Beal and get young assets and try to build for a few years from now when perhaps Wall's contract starts to become less of a burden? Or do you know that, hey, you already have an all-star in place in Beal? He's young. If you wait a few years, he'll still be in his prime because he's only 25 years old. And then you build around him and whatever else you can accumulate between now and then, knowing that you're probably not going to be in a position to contend for a few years anyway. So that's going to be the decision for the Wizards to make. And without a general manager in place, can they really make that decision moving forward? That's going to be another hurdle for the Lakers to clear. Now, all this is coming via Fletcher Mackel of NBC New Orleans. So he has had a number of comments about the Lakers and about their pieces. He is not a big fan of theirs. So I know a lot of Lakers fans are going to greet this news with a little bit of skepticism. He has been very high on the Boston Celtics assets and thinking a deal should get done with them. So I know that this is somebody that probably isn't near and dear to the hearts of Lakers fans, but it's something that he did put out there. He did say it's from a reliable source. So it's something that we should mention. And like I said, it makes a lot of sense for the Pelicans to covet Bradley Beal in a deal. You know, if they could get him, he would be a great fit for them. So we'll see what happens. We'll see if the Lakers can get that done or if they have to pivot to someone else or if perhaps the Pelicans just decide to give up going for another player and take the fourth pick themselves and just make the deal. We'll see. We know they want to get it done before the NBA draft, which is coming up on June 20th. All right, guys, for more on this story and everything else going on in the world of the Los Angeles Lakers, make sure you head over to LakersNation.com and keep it tuned right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel.